Hey guys, welcome back to the Saga channel, the home of the full face mask addict. Not that I ever wanted it to become that, but we've done a fair few videos on full face masks, and here we are, here you are. So here we go. Today we're going to talk about how to install the OTS Buddy phone on a full face mask. Could be a Spectrum, could be a Guardian, you know, same principle. So we're going to do it on a Spectrum today. So guys, if you like content like this, make sure to consider hitting that subscribe button, maybe give the video a like, and let's get started. Alrighty guys, so as we said, today we're going to install the OTS Buddy phone, an underwater communications system, on a Spectrum full face mask, right? So why might you want a Buddy phone? First of all, why could you want the ability to communicate underwater? It depends, guys. Maybe you're doing some more complicated stuff underwater, research. Maybe you're conducting an underwater search. Maybe you're trying to do a recovery of some sort. Or maybe you like to shoot videos underwater, like we do. And then it's really useful to communicate stuff that just isn't as easy or as, you know, quick as you would have used hand signals or a slate or something. What we're going to do right now is right here, I have an OTS Buddy phone. So comes with the actual transmitter receiver unit, and then the push to talk button and the microphone, right? So those need to be installed into the mask. Relatively straightforward, but we're going to do that together. And right here we have a Spectrum, an OTS Spectrum full face mask with the film still on the screen. Do you guys also find it so satisfying to remove stuff like that? I don't know, am I the only one? Let me know. So guys, right here we see that on the mask we have two ports, right? These can be removed and the communication system can be inserted. It's definitely designed to go on the right hand side. So that is the port that we are going to be removing. Now, every OTS product comes with one of these really cool wrenches that fit, of course, exactly in the port. So makes it very easy to remove. Nice and easy. That wrench makes it very, very, very convenient. And of course, we have on the inside here a port plug that will need to be removed, right? Next step, guys, is we're going to loosen a very similar screw, because it is, right? And it basically, it screws loose a bit, so you have a bit of a gap. That's where the seal is gonna be made between the inside portion of what holds the microphone and the outside portion, right? So now we can basically just slide the microphone into the port hole. And the tricky part here is that the inner part of the microphone holder needs to also go through the hole. That feels a little bit like you're gonna have to be a tiny, tiny bit forceful. Just watch out not to damage the microphone, of course. And there we go, it's in place, right? So next question you might ask is, how do we position the microphone? Very important to be mindful of, guys, is the microphone actually has a front written on it, because both sides do look a little bit similar. So make sure that the front portion is, of course, facing your mouth roughly. You'll be able to manipulate it a little bit, but as you install it, it's just nice to have it roughly in the correct position, right, guys? Then we're going to, of course, tighten the nut here, and of course we're gonna use that wrench to make sure that it's all nice and snug. So don't over tighten it, but the goal is, of course, to make sure we don't have a breach in the seal here, so water won't enter through our microphone port, right? There we go, that's pretty comfortably tightened here. There we go. And we're almost there, guys. The second part is, of course, to attach the buddy phone to the spider strap. That's even easier. Really, really straightforward here, guys. There's a little groove. We want to simply fit the side of the mask inside the groove and slide it a little bit. Maybe bring it back and forth a couple of times until it falls into the groove. There you go. And this is, of course, made so that it can slide back and forth a bit. So when you're donning the mask and adjusting the mask straps, you can slide that buddy phone right over your ear. Now, for the inside of the mask, guys, microphone placement is a big thing. You don't want it to obstruct, of course, the second stage intake, but at the same time, what you don't want either is for the skirt to hide the microphone, right? Because obviously if you have the skirt in front of the microphone, you're gonna have trouble really getting that signal across. So it's important to be mindful of where that's positioned, right? So let me have a look here. Can always give it a bit of a try and kind of visually confirm when your face is in the mask that the microphone is in front of your mouth, right? So that is it, guys. That is basically it. I would recommend when you use this system, make sure to, of course, rinse it thoroughly with fresh water. This is a studio grade microphone, really nice quality. However, keep in mind that the transmission mechanism, operates in a way that you're not gonna get high quality sound transmission, right? It's not gonna be the way that you're listening to me now. The microphone gets activated, or the transmission system gets activated by these two screws both being in contact with water, right? And then we can push to talk right here. So it's push and hold. Usually there's about a second of a delay when you start talking. So usually we will use a phrase like Nick speaking, and by the time that phrase has kind of run its course, the transmitter is going, right? Another thing that I learned the hard way is, of course, when you put the mask down, maybe you're on a boat or whatever, make sure you do not place the transmitter in a puddle of water, because as long as these two screws are connected via a medium such as water, the battery is being used, right? So you do run the risk of draining the unit a little bit if you place that in water. Be very gentle with it as well. Definitely don't bump it into anything, don't drop it. It's a very expensive piece of machinery, right? Last thing to think about is maybe how you want these wires to be routed. I find this personally to work quite well, but that's personal. Some people like it going from underneath to the side, whatever. And that is that. Now with the Spectrum in particular, guys, we do have a video on how to install the regulator. Something to think about, whether you want to put the regulator first or the microphone first, because they do get a little bit in the way of one another. But obviously, for the sake of this video, this gives you kind of the clearest view on how that all works. Now, we do have a promo code, guys, in the description, which you can use to buy your own Spectrum with BuddyPhone or Guardian with BuddyPhone with a 10% off coupon code. So that would be redeemed in the divestager.com/shop. Let me know what you think, guys, if this is a useful video. Maybe you have comments, maybe you're used to doing things differently. I'm definitely open to suggestions. And if you like this type of content, make sure to subscribe. Maybe leave a like, a comment. That always helps the channel out tremendously. Thanks for watching, guys, and I'll see you next time.